Hear me now?
Oh, that's brilliant.
Alright, great.
Okay, now the camera is up there above your head on the right, so
okay,
you have to
yeah.
keep smiling into that. And it picks up everything we say as well, so...
Yeah.
You know, don't say anything bad about Marcus.
Parental control.
Yeah. Okay, I'm just going to talk on the radio. We're called Classic Wing 7, and I'll get permission, and I'll talk to you as we taxi out, okay?
Yeah.
So Classic Wing 7, taxi clearance for 20 minutes to the north.
Classic Wing 7, Duxford, readability 5, taxi holding point, Bravo, runway 24 left hand circuit, BQNH 1006.
006, Bravo, 24, Classic Wing 7. Right, off we go then. So, I don't know whether you know much about these, but they're old classic training aeroplanes.
Yeah.
Designed in the 30s, they were used all the way through the war, and anything with a wheel at the back has got a, what they call a conventional undercarriage.
Yeah.
It means the engine sticks up in front of you, you can see nothing at all out the front.
Yeah, that's true.
So I'm having to zigzag left and right to see what's in front.
Yeah.
And it may seem obvious, but I saw a bloke taxi into a tree on Saturday, so broke his propeller and ruined his day.
Yeah.
It's got no brakes, so I have to take it very slowly.
Alright.
And obviously I don't aim at things.
On your 804 Duxford information, pass your message.
We're going to stop here and do our checks
yep.
for takeoff. Trimmer set. Throttle friction. Fuel is on, got plenty of fuel. Slats unlocked. Now, you've got an altimeter in front of you there.
804,
shut
Roger.
Up.
Report down.
It should be on zero now. I'm going to take you up to about 800 feet and then we'll level off.
Right.
With the engine full chat, difficult to hear really, so I'll give you a running commentary.
Okay.
And I don't really expect too much from reply until we get up there and levelled off. All right.
9K and decal about 1,000 feet.
Yeah, we'll let her finish talking and then we'll go. It takes off at about 45 knots.
Yeah.
And I'll climb away and cruise at about 60.
We've just got a very light shower passing through at the moment. Very light.
So we're down here 0804.
Classic Wing 7, ready for departure.
Classic Wing 7, Roger, take off your discretion. The service is southerly 10 knots.
Classic Wing 7.
And 7, just which direction are you operating in this time?
Thought we'd go north this time.
Roger.
So the runway is over here on these chalk marks,
yeah.
24 is short for 240 degrees, and we'll be giving it full power, getting the tail up, bouncing along until it gets airborne about 45, and then fly to the end of the runway and turn right.
Great.
Ready, steady, go. A bit better now, we bounce along at about 45, up into the air now.
Yeah.
And toodle along to the end of the runway and then turn right. 100 feet. Now 200 feet. Heading off towards the northwest here.
Yeah.
Not much I can really show you. Cambridge is off the right wing in the distance over there. Coming at 800 feet.
Good, Army Air 804.
Army Air 804.
Army Air 804, we're currently about to enter your area. Request a search up 500 feet on your QFE.
Army Air 804, Roger, no reported traffic to effect. My only request is avoid overflying Duxford Village, which is to the southeast of the airfield.
Avoid Duxford Village to the southeast of the airfield, 804.
There's a helicopter going past the left wing over there, just below us. That's the guy talking on the radio. Throttling back now and levelling off. Where do you live?
Sorry?
I didn't catch that.
Well, what did you say?
Okay.
Yeah.
Won't get there on this trip. As you can see, fairly gloomy day, but there are patches that's lighter than others.
Yeah.
Down on the right, just past the lake, you see the horse chestnut trees that have got this disease, and they're shedding their leaves a bit earlier.
Yeah, yeah,
I
see that.
Amir 804, downwind 424.
Amir 804, what do you know? Border traffic, report 75.
Edge of our Wilco servicewind.
Servicewind is 200 degrees 10 knots.
200 knots, that's copied 804.
This railway line goes underneath us and there's a train off to the left there. That's the Cambridge to London via Royston. Royston is the town in the distance there. Okay, we'll do your flying lesson if you're ready, Anton. Put your right hand on the stick and hold it gently.
Yeah.
Put your feet on the pedals.
Okay.
And look out the front window and you can see that the horizon goes through the top of the engine somewhere there.
Yeah.
And that's the picture you've got to memorise because that's straight and level.
Okay.
And we look out left and right and you can see the wings and they're about matched up on the horizon. So your head's got to be on a stick and looking in front and out to the sides.
Okay.
So that's the straight and level attitude. It stays there on its own really.
Yeah.
It's trimmed out about 800 foot on the altimeter.
Yeah.
And we're flying along nicely. Now if we bring the stick back just gently, the nose goes up.
Yeah.
And the altimeter goes up and we run out of speed, so then we have to push the stick forward to get it back on the horizon there.
Okay.
And if we push the stick forward, we make it go down a little bit. Airspeed builds up and we're in a dive. Now bring it back to the level flight, that's it. And bring the wings level as well. That's it. Now nose just on the horizon. Back to that picture that we had earlier, about there.
Yeah.
Now if we move the stick over to the right, we'll do that now, stick over to the right, it rolls and it keeps rolling until we stop it about there, centralised now.
Yeah.
Now we'll bring the wings level by moving stick to the left, when they come level we centralise.
Okay.
Got the idea? Hold it gently. It's a bit. You've got a bit of a big grip on there at the moment. Nose down just a little bit now. Other way, forward. That's it. To about there. Hold it there. And we're just going along the bottom of the clouds here. I'm going to turn to the right, so with me on the controls, we're going to put a little bit of right foot in now and bank it to the right. That's it, just enough. A little bit more bank. Around we go. Hold it gently, ever so gently. Now on the left you can see an old airfield.
Yeah.
That's where Memphis Belle operated from during the war. That's Bassingbourne Airfield. And now you can see on the right the stately home of Wimpole Hall.
Oh, great.
It's a wonderful drive, you know, avenue of trees. You can imagine them coming down there in their horse-drawn carriages.
Yeah.
Must be about 2 miles long this is, but you don't normally see it from the ground.
No, not at all.
Okay, we're going straight ahead now, and we'll fly along here, lower your nose just a little bit. There, okay. That's good. Now just hold the stick very gently, two fingers and a thumb, and the airplane will fly itself. You just adjust it now and again when it needs it, okay?
Yeah.
Good. Keep that nose on the horizon and keep the wings level. Level your wings. That's it, nose up a bit. Nose up a bit. That's good. Okay, we're going to turn to the right together now, so I'm with you on the controls. Bring the nose up. Nose up. That's it. Round to the right. And we'll go round the back of the Wimpole Hall and head back towards Duxford.
Yeah.
And straight ahead at that. Left bank and left rudder and then straight ahead there. You got it. Fly along like that at about 700 feet now. Don't go down anymore. Lovely. Wings level. Right, you have control and we'll do a gentle turn to the right now. Lovely. You see the formal gardens with the flowers out the back of the house?
Yeah, okay.
And then we come round here and there's the vegetable garden. Right, nose up a little bit. There's a castle down here on the left. We'll go round that. Okay, wings level. Moving it to the right now. Okay, I'll take control then.
Okay.
And I'll fly back to Duxford. You enjoy the ride,
yeah.
Okay?
Be great.
Trees are turning. Autumn's here. Now Duxford is just to the right of the nose in the distance,
yeah.
On the right hand side, right in the distance. On the left hand side you can see a radio telescope which belongs to the university, Cambridge University. Yeah. off to the left, this used to be a cement works, a quarry here. I think the French bought it a couple of years ago and they've laid everybody off, so there's nothing goes on there now.
That's too bad.
Get permission to go back.
Okay.
Duxford, Duxford 7, 4 miles northwest, right to rejoin.
Duxford 7, roger. Report right base, runway 24, left hand circuit, the QFE 1002.
Call your right base, 002 for 24, Duxford 7. So Duxford's in front of us now, you can see the hangars.
Yeah.
Sunshine here. That's the motorway M11 there on the left. Cambridge Hospital is off the left wing. Right in the distance, you see the big building. And then we follow the M11 down towards the airfield.
Roger, no reported traffic, report turning final.
Start to see the numbers where we're going to land.
Yeah.
24. Starting to throttle back now. Into the glide. Got the wind against us this way, so it's blowing across the runway actually.
Yeah.
So it's against us on this leg.
Okay.
Down we come, we keep coming down until we get to about 10 foot and then we bring the nose up and we have to get the nose up in the air as if we were taxiing along and then it falls the last 6 inches to the ground now. And we're down.
Well, it's been a pleasure.
Come again! Yeah, most enjoyable. So I'll switch the intercom off and then Pete will come and get you out. Alright.
Alright, thank you.